Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions. I'm Ron McKenzie Lafergy. Back in 1997, Jerry Ehman detected what he thought could have been radio signals coming from an alien civilization. This signal, called the WOW signal, after the notes written in Ehman's findings, has for decades been used as evidence that there is other intelligent life out there. But was this actually sent by aliens, or was it caused by something else entirely? Let's explore. If you want more science videos, check out our Biggest Science Questions playlist on the channel. Now get ready, it's time to ask the question, was the WOW signal from aliens? Since this is an event that not everyone is aware of, let's go over it in a bit more detail. In 1977, astronomer Jerry Ehman was using the Big Ear radio telescope at Ohio State University, aimed at the time at the constellation Sagittarius. At one point, he received a strong 72-second-long burst of radio waves, which he thought could signify something very important. He circled his findings and wrote WOW next to them, which would eventually bring about the name many associate with the signal. These findings have been held up for the last 40 years as proof that aliens are out there, with many assuming that these waves must be transmissions from them, similar to our own communication systems. However, it was recently hypothesized that this strange signal could have somewhat less interesting origins. A 2017 study by Antonio Paris from the Center for Planetary Science looked at radio signals over the course of a year, observing comets that had passed through the sky at the time of the WOW signal. It was determined that comet 266P Christensen emitted a radio signal at 1,420.25 MHz, the same as the readings of the WOW signal. This was further tested by looking at the readings of three other randomly selected comets, detecting a radio signal at 1,420 MHz from each one. These findings run counter to the idea that this signal came from aliens, instead indicating that it was from a comet, or the hydrogen cloud surrounding it. That said, these findings are not undisputed. Some astronomers, including Jerry Ehman, who originally noticed the signal, hold that it wouldn't explain why the signal seemed to be cut off abruptly. Critics also claim that the comet in question could not have sent such a strong signal, given its known characteristics. But Paris counters this with a claim that the comet may have been larger in 1977, and that the size of the Big Ear radio telescope may have also been in play. It's also pointed out that no such signals had previously been reported coming from comets, but Paris holds that this is due to a lack of research on the subject. It's even claimed that the comet was in the wrong place at the time to have caused the signal. However, whether or not it was the 266P Christensen comet in particular, this evidence does provide some support for a natural source of the signal. With phase 3 of Paris's study set to take place this year, we'll have to wait for more information on this. While the controversy rages on, scientists continue to search for proof of this signal's origin. Some are reluctant to accept the findings of Antonio Paris, but most scientists agree that the signal likely has origins in some planetary body, rather than an alien civilization. However, this is not to say that it's impossible that other alien life exists. We continue to search for signs and signals that could indicate alien life. The Search for Extraterrestrial Intelligence Institute, or SETI, employs a number of radio telescopes to aid in their constant quest for alien signals. The sheer number of planets makes it rather probable that some sort of alien life, possibly even intelligent life, exists elsewhere in the universe. For more on this, check out our video, What If Another Advanced Species Existed? And now we return to our question, was the WOW signal from aliens? Well, as of now, we still don't know for sure, but it's possible that it actually came from the hydrogen cloud surrounding a comet, which admittedly sounds somewhat less far-fetched than the alien explanation. As cool as it would be to have received a signal from aliens, the evidence we have seems to support the idea that the signal was a natural phenomenon, originating from a comet rather than an alien civilization. However, this won't stop us from continuing to look to the stars. Who knows? Maybe down the line we'll receive a bona fide communication from an alien race. Maybe we already have. Or maybe, just maybe, this video was made by aliens. Thank you for watching Life's Biggest Questions. I hope this was interesting and informative, and maybe even inspired you to look into it further on your own. If you like this video, please thumbs up and subscribe to the channel down below. While you're down there, let me know if you think the signal came from aliens, or a comet, or something else altogether. Until next time, I'm Ron McKenzie Lafergy with Life's Biggest Questions, wishing you the best of luck on your quest for answers.